Good to see even those who were not with us last week. I don't know what I should say. Happy New Year again to them because they were not here last week when we welcomed everyone back. But it's good to see you guys that we all made it back in one piece. The last time we saw each other was last year, but through His grace, we managed to come back together in one body, in one love.
Amen.
Amen.
It's not by our strength, but it's through this strength and through this grace and through the love that God always shows to us. Amen.
Amen.
Today the church remembers James Martha Dwane. Sorry if I pronounce it wrong, but it's James Martha Dwane. James Martha Dwane was born in the year 1848 in East Germany, and he was born in a family which were not believers, but he had a passion of being a believer, so he went out and then to study. After completing his studies, he went and started a church. And he drove lots of people in the community to come and be believers. But because the church that he wanted to start, it was a church that he wanted to start, a church that would relate to the context of people in the eating game. A church that relates the context in the form of bringing the culture and the church together. So he started a church that is known as Ethiopian movement. So through that church, in that area, most of the people, they went and worshiped there. And it's a church that is still forms a body of Catholic movement or Catholic tradition. So the bishop in that church, the first bishop in that church, was ordained, was consecrated by our bishop of the Anglican church. So Ethiopian church is not far from the Anglican church. We still share one belief with them. We still preach one gospel with them. Just that James Martin, the church that he introduced from the Anglican church, it was that we want the church that can relate with the context in that area. Amen. So we give thanks to the life of James Martin, who was not born in a Christian family, but far from that, he brings the church to the family and to the context in that area. And it matters to remember James Martin. Today we are celebrating the birthday of Lifa Mosoma Lerumo Maruma and the Abu Muruga. If you do know them, please send them the well wishes for their birthdays. And we are also celebrating the wedding anniversary of Blessings and Tokozani Watama, who will be spending 9 years in marriage. And yesterday, we were celebrating the wedding anniversary of Jenny and Joseph. They were celebrating their 45 years in marriage. and Lydian humanity. Let us keep them in our prayers day and night. We pray for them and we also call upon them to check up on how are they doing. Amen. And then the last one is that as you call up the cathedral is the healing center of those who feel God. So this year we found it fitting that the training for those who feel called, who at the moment is Mudau in Zwivhuya. This year we found it that as part of their training, they had to start preaching in the church. They can't say them, and as long they search and they look on it, and they both agree that it is fitting, they can start preaching in the church. So that they get used to preaching, so that they can get rid of the stage fear, because it's not easy to stand in front of the people. But they have to start learning how to do that. So today, on Sunday, Mudau was the one who preached for us. Today, Zwivhuya will be the one who will be preaching for us. So, all the best is God to see you. We need to deliver the message to us again. And we give thanks for raising people like you who will be patient to come and follow Him. Let us pray. Father God, you are the giver of life. You are the giver of everything that is good to us. We come to you this morning to say that you are holy and you are worthy, there is none like you. For Lord, as we are made from your love. We ask you, Lord, be with us today in today's service. Let your Holy Spirit, Lord, come and take control. We pray, Lord, in Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Our service continues from page 104 for those who are following on their Bibles. Nevertheless, I believe everything will be projected on the overheads. Just know that our overhead is giving us big challenges. So there and there, if you see something not going well, just pardon us. But we are trying all our best to get it fixed. My dear sisters and brothers, the Lord be with you. Praise the Lord. Blessed be God, Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Lord, we thank you for your message this morning. We thank you for bringing us to church. We thank you for the gift of life. As the song says, Lord, make us available for your calling. Let us be available whenever you want us to be, whenever you want us to help those in need, my Lord. And give us the wisdom, the courage, and guide us as we seek this path so that we can be your servants. Ask us in Jesus' name. Amen. Brethren, the song is singing to us. The Lord is looking for faithful servants who can lead his church. We all have different gifts, and the Lord is simply saying to us, avail yourself, I will hold your hand and invite you. You will never be alone. My plea to you is that as we go back home, let us take out our hymn books and look into the lyrics of this song so that we can interpret it and be able to understand what the Lord is saying to us individually. And let us also believe that through Him, it is possible for us to champion this cause. As well as we walk with Him, we know that we are strengthened. Amen. We are now proceeding on paragraph 5. Glory to God in the highest,
and peace to His people on earth.
Lord God,
to the
God our Father,
our Father.
Please.
Jesus said to the crowd and to his disciples, the teacher of the law and the Pharisee sit in Moses' seat, so you must be careful to do everything they tell you to do. But do not do what they do, for they do not practice what they preach. They tie up heavy load and put them on other people's shoulders, but they themselves are not willing to lift a finger to move them. Everything they do is done for the people to see. They made their while they cast on their garment cloth, they love the place of honor and banquet, and the most important thing is synagogue. They love to be treated with respect in the marketplace and to be called rabbi by others. But you are not to be called rabbi, for you have one teacher, and you are all brothers. And do not call anyone on earth father, for you have one father, and he is in heaven. Nor are you to be called an instructor, for you have one instructor, the Messiah. The greatest among you, you will be your servant, for those who exalt themselves to be humble, and those who humble themselves will be exalted. This is the gospel of Christ. I greet you all in the wonderful name of Jesus Christ. Amen. We may sit. It's not easy at all to stand in front of you and preach the word. As much as maybe I'm used to the idea of preaching, maybe in the morning prayers, but to stand maybe today and just preach the word, it's not easy at all. If I make a mistake, please forgive me for that. Today, allow me to look in the book of Matthew, chapter 23, starting from verse 1 until verse 12. From today's gospel, it gives us a narrative about Jesus speaking with the crowd. It told us that among the crowd in which Jesus was addressing, there were disciples. But the strange thing about this meeting which Jesus was having, he was warning the crowd and the disciples that you must be aware. You must obey and follow everything that they teach you to do. Do not, however, imitate the action. The question is, maybe who were he speaking about? He was speaking about the law, the teacher of the law and the Pharisees. At this point, Jesus is warning the crowd and the disciples that do what they told you to do, but don't do what they do. It's still confusing. What is it making? Is it making sense? I don't know. But he's saying that do what they told you, but don't do what they do. Why? As I go further, the Bible tells us that it's because they don't practice what they do. Allow me to pose this question, in which is going to serve us my thing today. Does our action match our beliefs? Does our action match our beliefs? Does our action match our beliefs? I want us to look within ourselves and ask ourselves, You must do what they tell you to do, but don't do what they do. The first thing to make is that he has provided us, but they don't have this for the fruit. But the other thing is that these roses, they took man-made rules seriously as God will. They don't know how to differentiate between the two. They don't know how to differentiate that this is a God law, this is a man-made rules. The other reason in which maybe Jesus was looking at is that these people, the Pharisees, they told each and every one to obey the rules, but they themselves were not even obeyed. It leads me maybe to ask myself that what kind of relationship maybe these Pharisees will portray? Jesus himself, he portrayed a relationship of saying, I will follow the way and also walk the way. But the Pharisees at this point, they were the people who just walked to the way, but they never wanted to walk the way. And I think to other reasons why Jesus was saying to them that do what they told you, but then do what they do. They obey rules to obey, not to obey, not to obey or to honor God, but to make them look good. I can see maybe the Pharisees, maybe on today's world we can see maybe they were having a master's, they were having maybe a doctorate. You can see them by the walk, the way they walk, that this person maybe is highly educated. They say they honor, they don't honor God, but they honor the fact that they must look good in the public. Among our own patients, we have such people. And even ourselves, we have gone to the road that we have taken some habit of maybe following that thing without being aware that what we are doing is wrong. We have even our congregation people who live like the Pharisees. They know the law, but they choose to live from it. We have in our congregation people like the teachers of the law. They know the law, but they don't practice what they practice is, they don't practice what they preach. We have in our congregation those who say that they are born again Christian, but the standard of living or the way that they portray it, we can't say maybe these people are the born again people. We have among ourselves the Christian. We say we are Christian, but the behavior does not match with the standard of Jesus. We have among ourselves those who say that we are the children of God, but they don't practice the art of forgiveness. Each and every Sunday and Wednesday, as we do the Lord's Prayer, we say that forgive our wrong we have done, as we forgive the wrong for others we have done to us. But see in their heart, the whole practice, they say that I want to forgive you for what he has done. We have among ourselves those who we see that maybe is Christian because they have come to church on Sunday or Wednesday, but as they leave, they portray another character. The Pharisees know the scripture, but they choose not to live by them. They do not care about being holy. All they wanted was just to look good. All they care about was for them to receive the adoration and praise from the people. Even today's world, we still see such. People know the Bible, but they don't allow the Bible to change them. People say that they follow Christ, but they don't live by the standard of Jesus Christ, which was love. We must be aware that our action balance our beliefs. They often say that whatever you do on the right, you must also do on the left. It must be balanced. As I draw maybe to completion, allow me to give you a story about this young man and his mother. It says one morning, they were sort of like getting up from the beach. It says his mother has to see his child from the distance. It says, why don't you have to go sideways? The mother said to the young man, can't you just walk maybe straight forward without even going maybe sideways? The young man just obeyed, saying, mother, can you just teach me how to walk? The mother told the boy, saying, let me teach my son how to walk. he tried to walk, maybe straight to forward, he just goes sideways. Each and every time he tried to walk straight forward, he goes sideways. Until to a point where, as he tried to do it again, he fell by the nose. What am I saying to the story to you this morning? Don't tell others how to act unless you set a good example. Don't say to them that they must carry a Bible, or else you never carry a Bible even in a day. Don't tell them maybe that they must walk this way whenever you never walk that way. You don't even know how hard it is, but you're already coaching them. The mother choir were like Pharisees. They preach, but they don't do what they preach. As Christians, let us learn to balance the two, our action and our belief. People must not assume that we are Christian. They must not see by the way we live, the way we talk. Maybe the answer maybe to my question is saying, does our action match our beliefs? Maybe among ourselves, maybe this, I'm always asking myself, how can I balance the two? By allowing Christ to be the center of our life. This is what's going to happen. As maybe I hold this Bible on this other hand, maybe I try to hold this one. This one is behavior than this one. This one, each and every time, maybe if I try to get it out, this one will always be lower than this one. But as I put Christ maybe to the center of my life, this one here, the salvation is Christ. But then I see maybe this thing, this balance between this one and this one. Allow Christ to be the center of our life. It's where our action and our belief, they go to balance. In the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Amen.
We are challenged this morning. The Lord is what outside is inviting us to come and play a role in different ministries so that we can make Jesus the center of our lives and make balance in our lives. As we go out, let us introspect and reflect on the wonderful ways that we have received and be relevant to the church. May we all stand for the example. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty,
we believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the Holy Spirit.
worship your word, giving us a task to question ourselves, that does our actions match our beliefs. Heavenly Father, let those words be the words that rings in our lives, so that we may come to you and not be like the Pharisees and the teachers of the law. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, you have taught us to pray and give thanks for all people. Receive our prayers for the universal church, that it may be the power of your Spirit, and that all the children may agree in the truth of your holy word and live in unity and godly love. We pray for your servant, Luke, our bishop, together with Charles, our metropolitan, and for all the ministers of your word and sacrament, that by their life and teaching, your glory may be revealed and all nations may be drawn to you. Guide and prosper, we pray, those who strive for spread of your gospel, and enlighten with your Spirit all things by name. We pray for those who have authority and responsibility among the nations, especially Senator Mufasa, our President, that ruling wisdom and justice, they may promote peace and well-being in the world. To this congregation and to all people in their different colonies, give your heavenly grace that we may hear your holy word with reverent and obedient heart, and serve you truly all the days of our lives. In your compassion, Father, comfort and heal those who are troubled, sorrow, needy, or sickness, especially those who have asked the church to pray for them. We praise and thank you for all your saints, for the Blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of Jesus Christ, our Lord, and for the heroes of faith in every generation. We remember before you your servants who have died, praying that we may enter with them into the fullness of your unending joy. Grant this, Holy Father, for Jesus Christ's sake. Amen.
The Lord is dead. And Jesus said, for those who exalt themselves will be humbled, and those who humble themselves will be exalted. My dear sisters and brothers, the peace of the Lord be with you.
Peace be with you.
This is how it is here, isn't it? Holy Spirit, the giver of life, amen. The bread which you break is not the shedding of the blood of Christ.
We are the
to have to this
We thank you, Lord. And we pray for each and everyone, Lord, who's here without this morning. You know their needs to be before they ask you, Lord. You know their prayer request, Lord. Lord God, we ask you, Lord God, be gracious to them and answer their prayers, Lord. Even though we ask from you here, Lord, we bring them before you. Thank them, Lord. Stretch your hands upon them. Your hand of blessing. Your hand, Lord, which even things when they have gone accordingly. Your hand, Lord, always called them and put everything according to the order. We send you the Holy Spirit. In Christ Jesus. Amen. Give thanks the Lord for his gracious. keep them in our prayers, even those who will be traveling from our diocese to go and support them. And then, on the 1st of March, is Shrove Tuesday, the day we elect most of the pilgrims. Last year we didn't get time to share pilgrims together because of COVID. But the preparations are undergoing. We hope that this year we will have that opportunity to come together to share pilgrims. And then if you notice on the notice box, there is a message which is plugged there, which is requesting the assistance of those who want to be members of the committee which will be preparation, which will be doing the preparation of Shelf Tuesday. I know Priscilla, you are one of them. I know you are one of them. Yes. And then one other event will follow, and then I believe that we all received the Cathedral annual calendar. If you don't receive any, please go to the office, they will send it to you, and they will also try to see how come you don't receive any. Maybe the information that we have of you is incorrect in the church books. So if you didn't receive the church annual calendar, please go to the office and talk to the administrator and to see how to sort it out. And even if you don't receive any communication from the church, go to the head to assist you. And the last one is to say thank you and thank you to everyone who is being faithful at the Lord. I hope you all understand what I mean by being faithful. Who's been faithful at the Lord by giving their tenth to the Lord. Because the church needs your tenth so that it can survive with all the things that it needs to pay. Without your tenth, the church won't be able to function. And we also want to say thank you to those who continue to take care of the ministers here in the church, of the ministers in the church. We really appreciate it. Thank you for that. And also those who continue to pray for us, thank you for your prayers. It's through your prayers that we are able to stand before you and save you. We really thank you for that. The baptism and confirmation applications are open. The forms are available at the back. And then the due dates, I'm not sure about the due dates, but if you notice on the notice box, there is a due date of when the last form should be returned. Please, if you have a child or if you have a family member who needs to be baptized, take the form and take it to them for completion, and you tell them to the office before the 2 days so that things will be able to run smooth. Thank you. Above all, we love you a lot. Thank you.
It is therefore